Good morning to all the students. Yes, Vita. Today we will revise poetry. And I'm expecting no noise should intervene in my teaching learning process. Karthike, this is the last time I'm taking your name. After this, I'll be asking you to leave the class only. Don't give instructions to others. Fine, first poem is Dust of Snow. And poet is Robert Frost. Kindly note down. And we'll be doing value points of this poem first. So let's see how many poems we can do. At least, I guess, two poems only we'll be able to complete in one period. Okay? And both poems of Robert Frost only, so that it becomes permanent in your memory. So Dust of Snow. I was telling you, in MCQs, you can get confused whether it is Dust of the Snow, the Dust of Snow, or Dust of Snow in that way. Clear? You should be very clear that there is no article in this name. So Dust of Snow is the name of the poem and Robert Frost is the poet. So let's start with the value points. So this is written by very famous American poet, Robert Frost. Clear? First of all, we have written the name. Now the value points. First value point is about, it is a winter's day. The atmosphere, you can say, weather is, it is a winter's day. Clear? Everybody should be very attentive, last boy also. So the treetops, I'm telling you the scene of the poem, fine? It is a wintry day. And treetops are snow covered. Clear? Second point is, treetops were covered with snow. Is it visible to all? Snow covered treetops. Clear? Then the poet was walking under one such snow-covered tree. So we just got to know in this poem that poet Robert Frost, he's sharing one of his experience. He's saying that it was a wintry day and treetops were covered with snow. And he happened to pass by and he was going through, exactly it is not mentioned. So he was walking under a snow-covered tree. So poet was under, you can say poet was walking or standing, anybody you can use here. So poet was walking under one such tree. One such tree means one snow-covered tree only. Clear? Then after that, very important aspect now, such sort of objective questions will be there. They can ask about the which tree is mentioned in the poem Dust of Snow. It can be oak, pine, hemlock and all. And you all know that. Then it was a hemlock tree. In objectives, beta, thorough knowledge is tested. Subjective mein toh bahut gap mein lagate the. You used to write anything, whatever you felt like, okay. Har bachche ka answer vary karta tha. Here uniformity will be there. One answer is correct and you have to choose. Fine. So if you have read the chapter thoroughly, bar bar mein yehi keh rahi hu, then you will be preparing for revision tests before exams. As well as for exams, you have to read the chapter rather than mugging up the learning the question answers, fine? Read the chapter and your work is done and read with understanding, not just for the sake of. So it was a hemlock tree. Stop giving bottles here and there, jaldi se beta, please. And after that, then poet has mentioned, Robert Frost has mentioned qualities of a hemlock tree. Hemlock tree is considered a poisonous tree. Fine. So qualities associated with the tree are, it is considered poisonous. Write down next point. Poisonous tree. इट इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड अ साइन ऑफ गुड ओमन, इट इज कंसिडर्ड वन ऑफ द इल ओमन, फाइन, बैड साइन यू कैन से. सो इट इज अ पॉइजनस ट्री. Hemlock is considered poisonous tree. After that, what happens? Suddenly, a crow alighted this poisonous tree. Crow alighted means suddenly enters. A crow alighted, GHTED. And you need to, you know, revise a lot. You need to be very strong in when it comes to vocabulary. 5 to 6 questions will be based on vocabulary only. Alighted means a sudden arrival. Fine. So crow alighted the hemlock tree. The sudden arrival of the crow onto the tree. So poet was standing or walking under the poisonous tree, and it was very wintry day, and tree tops were covered with snow. Tree leaves were not visible even, and when it seems to be very dull day. But suddenly a crow alighted the hemlock tree. Clear to all of you? I will be asking questions. मैं आराम से आपको करवा रही हूँ ये chapter or poem or anything. And when I ask you, you should be answerable. After that, beta, when a crow alighted the tree, then sudden movement of crow. What happened then? Yes, sudden movement of the crow, it led to falling of snowflakes on the poet. Sudden movement leads to falling of snowflakes. So when crow entered the tree, a movement, another word for movement is commotion. C-O-M-M-O-T-I-O-N. Commotion means movement. So a commotion started, a movement started on the tree. Snowflakes fell down upon the poet who was standing under the tree. Fine. Firstly, when crow entered, movement started. Then finally, you write down snowflakes. Fell upon poet who was standing under the tree. Snowflakes fell upon the poet. Yes, children sitting at home, you will be showing me your notebooks where you are writing. You're taking the advantage of sitting at home that you will, you know, miss the habit of writing only. बहुत इजी होता है ऐसे घर पे बैठ के कहीं पे भी इजीली बस वो लेक्चर ऑन कर लो whether you're listening or not. Only a few are there who are attentive. No noise. Commotion and accommodation. They are two far away different terms. Accommodation is when somebody is residing in a place. Accommodation wanted. A place to reside wanted, it means. A place where you live. That is accommodation. Clear? And commotion is noise. A movement. When birds enter the tree, a commotion starts. Two different things, fine? So, sudden movement leads to falling of snowflakes or dust of snow. One and same thing. Snowflakes or dust of snow. Fell upon poet. Clear? And it seems to be, next point is, it seems to be ordinary happening. It seems to be ordinary act, you can say. But it seems to be ordinary act, A-C-T. But it gives, it leaves tremendous effect. Tremendous means vast or big. Tremendous effect on poet. ट्रिमेंडस चॉक्स कहां पर रखे बेटा आपने? हरसिमरन गिव मी द चॉक्स प्लीज, इधर से दे दो। ट्रिमेंडस मीन्स वास्ट और बिग, क्लियर? दो इट इज एन ऑर्डिनरी एक्ट, थैंक यू बेटा, इट सीम्स टू बी वेरी ऑर्डिनरी थिंग दैट ही वॉज स्टैंडिंग अंडर द ट्री, इट स्टार्टेड शेकिंग एंड स्नोफ्लेक्स फेल. Otherwise, it seems to be very boring and dull day. Nothing was happening, no movement, no commotion. Poet was also feeling very bad. But suddenly when he was standing under the hemlock tree, which bird entered? Yes, it can be, they can write pigeon, eagle, crow, and the other one, obviously you should know. Those who are attentive listeners, right? So crow alighted the tree. Crow and hemlock both are considered associated with sadness, dejection, depression, or you can say negativity. Clear? Ill omens, a sign of ill omens. कई बार होता है ना that you are going somewhere and cat passes by, you say okay बिल्ली ने रास्ता काट लिया, I'm not going to move further. So this is one myth only. There is no reality behind that. So it's just associated with your feelings only. So, when falling of the fine snowflakes on the poet, it leaves a tremendous effect before that. So, write down some points. Now, I won't be writing. Write down few more points and we are done with this poem. Before this act, ACT, comma, poet was in a state of gloom. Poet was in a state, S-T-A-T-E, state of gloom, G-L-O-O-M. Gloom means sadness, dejection. So these are synonyms only. Before this, poet was in a state of gloom. Why you people have different moods every day? Cha, do you feel happy every day? We are human beings. Fine. So there is no answer to this. Why? Because we are human beings. We face various different emotions. One day we are happy. Sometimes you feel bad for no reason. Fine. Sometimes you're tired enough. Sometimes, you know, weather changes also, you know, affect the mood. You know that. These days, stickiness is there. Ek to bahut zyada garmi hai. Fine. And you people are listening to the lecture, which is not capturing your attention. Then how do you feel? Gloomy, dejection, same way. And suppose it's a very pleasant weather. And, but in your case, it does not apply even. Chahe mausam achha ho ya bura, aapko to padhna hi nahi hai. So this does not apply on you, fine? So jokes apart, you got the answer, let's continue then. So poet was in a gloomy or you can say despairing state also. Despair also, one of the synonym of gloom, clear? Then, but this simple or, yes, Kartike, let's continue, come back. This beautiful act or this simple act of nature, fine, was very soothing for the poet. Clear? It was very soothing for the poet. It gave him satisfaction ki, okay, some movement is there at least. Otherwise, there was no movement. The weather was dull. But that movement changed his attitude, fine? So what happened after effects of this act now? When snowflakes fell upon the poet, he felt this, he was feeling good. And then it had good impact on the mental state of the poet. He became happy after this, clear? And he already had decided, kai baar hote na ki kuch, हम घर से निकलते हैं, वी स्टार्ट थिंकिंग ओके एवरीथिंग इज बैड, दिस वर्ल्ड इज यू नो इट्स ऑल इन अवर माइंड, इट्स माइंड गेम. इफ वी फील बैड, एवरीथिंग विल बी इन अवर सराउंडिंग्स, वी स्टार्ट फीलिंग नेगेटिव ओनली. बट इफ वी आर पॉजिटिव इनफ, वी गेट पॉजिटिविटी फ्रॉम एवरीवन. सो ऑलरेडी ही हैड मेड अप हिज माइंड दैट नथिंग गुड इज गोइंग टू हैपन. वो पहले ही वो नेगेटिव होकर घर से निकला था. एंड नो मूवमेंट वॉज देयर, नो पीपल वर देयर, नो बर्ड कुड बी सीन इन सच you can say snowy weather. So when he was standing there, ही वॉज ऑलरेडी डिजेक्टेड, पहले से ही वो सैड था. सो ही ऑलरेडी थॉट दैट दिस इज अ वेस्ट, यू कैन से डे इज टोटल अ वेस्ट फॉर हिम. So there is nothing, no outcome will be there in on that particular day. But this act added some newness into his day. So he then changed his mind from dejection to happiness. Clear? So at least then he remarked, last mein usne kya bola, at least the part of the day is saved. So you can write, he felt that at least the part of the day was saved. Agar pura din achha nahi tha, to at least this movement was good. He felt at least part of the day was good enough. Clear? So he felt that one part of the day was good enough. Clear? So last line is, if this act would not happen with him, he would have, you know, thought that he wasted his day. So this act actually saved his day. This small natural act of, last line is, this small natural act of falling off snowflakes actually saved his day. Clear? So now, after this poem, what do you feel the central idea of the poem is about? Yes, optimism, very good. What else? How you feel, it's all in your mind. Fine. So actually, our mental state, you know, is very, you can say, important role to play. Whatever you feel in your mind, you start behaving like that only. If you're not feeling good, you will, you know, talk with others in a very bad way. So mental state should be good enough. This poem also teaches about the feeling of optimism. One should always be optimistic, positive approach towards life rather than being negative and dejected. Clear? If we are dejected, everything seems to be dejected. If we are happy, everything seems to be, you can say, good. So in that way, optimism should be there. Fine. And our mental state should be balanced. We should not be, you know, feeling very bad in one particular state of mind. So this is it. Then we will be doing another poem. After this poem, we will do MCQs. Literary devices. For that, do you have the book beta with you? Give it to me. Metaphor is used here. Metaphor is direct comparison. Dust of snow. Rather than saying that snow was looking like dust particles, directly they are calling it dust of snow. So comparison is made. So this is metaphor. Fine. When comparison is made by using as or like, that becomes a simile. But this is the example of metaphor. You already had written beta. Imagery is used. Yes, most of imagery is used. What is imagery? When such words are used which form or creates images in your mind. Snow-covered mountain is the example. Underline imagery. Snow-covered mountains. Sorry, snow-covered treetops. They have written the hemlock tree. It is also imagery. लिखा हुआ है आपने सब. क्लियर? डस्ट ऑफ स्नो एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मेटाफर. देन सिंबलिज्म इज यूज्ड व्हेन वन वर्ड डिनोट्स सम अदर मीनिंग. कार्तिके एंड परीक्षित. फाइन. विवान. यू वांट टू बी फेमस विद योर नेम. फाइन. सो इमेजरी में क्या क्या आएगा? हेमलॉक एंड they have not used the words that I was telling you wintry day, but it is not mentioned here. Hemlock is an imagery. Metaphor is dust of snow is a metaphor. The name of the poem itself. Clear? So let's move to next poem again by Robert Frost. fire and ice. We have 10 minutes with us. But you have to be quick enough to note down. You're very, you know, you show such a reaction that I start feeling bad enough. Poem 2. Yes, is it clear to all the children? The online students also, send your feedback. Hanji beta. There was no movement on the tree earlier. When a bird came, only then movement started. Maybe he was sitting and he flied, but movement was there. Alighted, I'm not saying the crow was flying somewhere and he entered the tree. That's why we use the word alighted. That means sudden movement only. Clear? It can be already crow was sitting or it entered. That nobody knows. But alightment is there. Clear? That's why. So Fire and Ice is again written by Robert Frost. Yes, better let me write down the value points first. When I turn, then you start talking. Write down first point now. Yes, the poet feels that this world of ours will come to an end. Poet feels that world will come to an end. So this is the feeling of the poet. Robert Frost. Poet feels that world will come to an end. He's not clear about when that end will come. Fine. So he knows that, he feels that. Fine. Not knows. Yes, Shahad and Navya. Sorry, Tanya. He knows that world will come to an end. When and how, that he doesn't know, but he feels that definitely world of ours will come to an end in the beginning of the poem. So finally he made up in his mind only, he comes to a conclusion on the basis of what other people say on this subject. Fine. So he considers opinion of others, other people. He is using the word, na, they say and all. That shows that he considers the opinion of others. He also feels that world will come to an end, but how, that he doesn't know. So that's why he considers the opinion of others. He comes to the conclusion on the basis of what other people say. And there are two sides or two category of people. One first category of people believe in the world will end in fire. The other set of people or other strata of the society. Strata means a segment, group, category. Clear? One and same thing. Strata, group, category, side. Fine. World will end in fire. The other set, world will end in ice. You will not write like this. Fine. The other set of people, they believe that the world will end in ice. Fine. Now, we need to understand. Again, you were asking about beta. Good, you just highlighted the poetic devices. Again, symbolism is used here in this poem. In abundance, bahut zyada. Kaise? Fire and ice. Both are symbolic of some attitudes in our lives. Fine. People who believe that world will end in fire. Now, fire belongs to the people who are passionate. Fine? Who are very passionate, who are very ambitious. Who are ambitious? Those who can do anything for the sake of their achievements. Anything means anything. Fine? So, the people who are full of fire, it means they are full of passion. These attributes are there. They are ambitious. दे आर फुल ऑफ एंगर ऑल्सो फाइन दे आर फिरोशियस सो दीज ट्रेट्स आर एसोसिएटेड विद द पीपल हु आर फुल ऑफ पैशन सो सेकेंड कैटेगरी इज आइस द पीपल हु आर cold and numb. Now, what do you mean by cold and numb here? Insensitive. Lack of sympathy and empathy in them. Unko koi farak hi nahi padte. Whether you are dying or living. Fine? The people who are cold and numb means, does not mean ice wala cold. It means people who have feeling of indifference. Indifference word bhi likh lo. Those who have feeling of indifference, unko koi farak hi nahi pad raha hai. Fine. So the people who are insensitive to their surroundings, who are cold and numb, who have the feeling of indifference towards others. Clear? So they represent ice. Bisam, numb means not depressed here. Cold and numb feeling ka baat hai. When you are supposed, I give you one literal example. You are standing in icy cold weather and you do not have proper jackets to wear. How do you feel? That aapki body shake nahi kar pa rahi, move nahi kar pa rahi. You are stuck to a place. You start feeling cold and numb. In that way, I am using this word. Numb here does not mean depressed. Numb here means the people who do not have any feeling. Clear? So, clear meaning of fire and ice. These are symbols here. Now, after that, poet says, he seems to show agreement of what people say about the ending of the world. What poet believes? Poet believes that the world will come to an end by two highly contrasting but powerful elements of nature, fire and ice. Poet believes that world will definitely come to an end with the, you can say, due to these two elements only. Fire and ice. But whom does poet favor? Yes, poet favors those who favor fire. Clear? Means he believes that people who are very passionate, overconfident, overambitious, putting in, you can say, by hook and by crook, they want to survive. Cutthroat competition is going on in this society. So these are the people who will lead to end of this world. Clear? According to poet. Both conditions are bad in a way. But poet believes that world will end in fire. Fine. So then after disclosing his favor, poet tells us that either fire or ice, fine, both will be the, you can say, cause of destruction. Both are not good. Dono destruction leke aa sakte hain. Why? He starts linking that powerful natural elements to ye point likh lo aap. Poet associates these two natural elements to human beings. Poet associates these two natural elements to human beings. Clear? Fire and ice ko usne human beings ki nature ke saath, behavior ke saath associate kiya hai. Clear? And at the end, poet believes that both can destroy the world. Clear? We will do MCQs tomorrow. Have a nice day.